keep getting bigger. Ooh, a red ear. You know, I gotta get your picture and send it to somebody. You already cheered me up, so let's spread it around.
Hey, Layla, would a turtle make a good fish bait? Would you bite one?
Howdy, folks. Well, I had high hopes about Spring Fork Lake, south of Sedalia, there in Pettis County, Missouri. Plan A was to fish Ned rigs, and typically I would go down along the dam and just tear them up. But after fishing it about an hour with nothing, I tied on one of those little minnows jig, and that worked really, really well.
Now the next mod is made from a TRD minnows. And this one is called the minnows. If it's suspended under a cork and twitched a little bit, the little Elastec tail has a little fin on the very end. It absolutely looks alive. However, it's been really, really effective by just dropping it to the bottom. And while it's sitting down there, if there's any movement at all of your rod tip, it just lights up. Okay, here are the water conditions. Guess what? No waders. Yay! In no particular order, today I'm going to tell you everything I know about bluegill. Catching anything today? One of the many advantages of the kick float version of the Pit Boss is that you can literally get right in the middle of all these pads and hydrillas and stuff like that and just pick them apart, literally. For their size, they are really good fighters. Tell me this isn't fun. See ya. If you're fishing from the bank, lily pad stems, they will wrap you around it so fast. And then that's adios. If you're plastic worming, these are the kind of fish that drive you nuts because you'll get yanked and you'll bring your worm in and its tail is gone bye-bye. We've recently seen that they are abiding many times up in real shallow water. See, that's a nice keeper-sized bluegill right there. That's a nice one. Oops. And if you like salad, the hits keep coming. Just a comment or two about this kick float configuration and all this hydrilla and lily pads. First time I've really ever tested it in this stuff, and it does really, really well. Every now and then you have to kick off some hydrilla from your flippers. But the kick float just glides right over it. Naturally, I lifted my transducer up in the back. This water right here cannot be more than a foot deep, but nonetheless, there's fish in that super shallow water. Your bobber fishing, you'll see your bobber go bloop, doot, doot. But they don't seem to do that as much with these Elastec minnows. They just engulf them. You can bet there's not just one, there's a bunch of them in there. A bunch of them will band together in the same area, probably having a bluegill party of some sort. Mm-hmm. Had a little too much to drink last night.
This little area right up in here is a place to come and bring a fish basket sometimes, because these are really nice. Okay, so we were just sort of trolling along out here in 9 feet of water. Oh boy. Of course, once again, it's on a very tiny hook, and that is just fraught with danger. Yeah, that's a good fish. Perfect, you stuck your landing. Whoops, that shows you how he wasn't hooked. Nice, it's a beautiful fish. Really stocky. I'm going to say maybe 18, 17, 18. Why guess? Once again, this was a case of calibrated eyeballs. Check it out. I'll call it 17 and 3/4. Very nice. I'll be the first to admit you're the last fish I expected to catch trolling with a little minnows, but nice to meet you. And that's three in a row. Three casts in a row. And look at the colors they've turned to in that bright sunlight and dark hydrilla. Beautiful. I can't actually call these casts. They're just pitches. I've got out about 10 feet of line from the tip to the lure, and I'm just pitching them out there. It seems to be working. I challenge anybody to find a sport as fun as bluegill fishing. You're not gonna do it. No, I'm not catching the same fish over and over. These are all different fish. The only thing the same is the pocket. Wow. Sixth one, same pocket. Seventh one, same pocket. Gee whiz, they keep getting bigger. Wow, that's a dandy right there. Just keep getting bigger. I'm not even going to try to estimate how many bluegill there are in that little pocket. Let's just say it's lots. Astonishing. Beautiful. I'm starting to impress myself. So what do you guys think of my minnows, huh? Pretty cool. And you love them. I'll show you how they change colors in front of your eyes. Okay, now keep an eye on the color. Okay, now watch. Watch it change colors right in front of your eyes. See how orange it is?
Getting darker, getting darker, getting darker. Hey, what happened to your orange? Isn't that something? Look at that little chameleon. Ooh, a red ear. This is a very thick-bodied, heavy fish. It's got that black and orange flesh. And look at the size of this monster. And he sure tended to grow larger because he's over 10 inches. You know I gotta get your picture and send it to somebody. You already cheered me up, so let's spread it around. It's a pleasure meeting you. Thanks everybody for going along today. We'll catch you next time. Once again, the Minners mod was unbelievably good. I'm glad I got to share everything I know about bluegill. Be safe, enjoy the month of June, and God bless.